Hello and welcome to StudyIQ. In this video of StudyIQ, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the first week of June. I will cover first 6 days, that is till 6th of evening I will cover, and 7th of June I will cover in the next video, which will be on 12th of June. I will bring it a little earlier because on 12th I am going to Himachal for some work for 10 days, and therefore I will put it on 12th morning itself, the second week video, and the whichever days remain I will cover that in the third week video. And if you want to buy any of our pen drive courses, that is the number that you have to dial, 9580048004. These are the best selling pen drives, SSC, CGL and IBPS PO right now. And UPSC pen drive, the much awaited UPSC pen drive, we are launching on 9th of June. Please note that on 9th of June at 2 PM in the afternoon, our senior faculty Bhumika Saini, who has cleared UPSC this time with an All India rank of 664, she will take a live stream on our YouTube channel. So do join in and ask your doubts, if any. So let's begin. There is a recent study by Kiwi.com website, and according to this, what is India's rank on best valued air ticket prices on its domestic and international routes worldwide? So all the aviation companies in India, the airlines companies, do they price their tickets at a premium or is it cheap as per this ranking? So India is third, which shows that the Indian airlines, they price their tickets in a value for money format, and India was the first in 2016, but this time India is third. And first country is Malaysia, second country is Bulgaria. Bulgaria is a European country with capital at Sofia, and Malaysia is a Southeast Asian country, capital at Kuala Lumpur. Now please also note that our government launched a scheme called Udaan, which is Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. This scheme has very low ticket prices for the underserved and unserved airports. And Assam was the first state to adopt Udaan scheme. So keep these things in mind. With which country has India agreed to build an energy bridge and enhance the cooperation in energy sector? Energy bridge, for making sure that India's energy security is not compromised, we have teamed up with Russia. Russia, Vladimir Putin is the president, Moscow is the capital, and ruble is the currency, which has been on a decline for the past few years because of economic sanctions imposed by America and European Union. Now these are the four countries which our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji visited recently: France, Russia, Germany and Spain. And you should know the executive head of all the four. Mariano Rajoy is the Prime Minister of Spain, Germany's Chancellor is Angela Merkel, Russia's President is Vladimir Putin, and France's new elected President from En Marche party is Emmanuel Macron. These are very important people. And with Russia together, we have signed five pacts we have signed with Russia. A 3-day Modi Fest was celebrated pan-India because the NDA government, National Democratic Alliance, that is BJP plus friends, is called NDA. So BJP has a lot of friends like Shiv Sena, like Akali Dal and all these. So together they are called National Democratic Alliance. It has completed 3 years, and Modi stands for what as per this fest? So Modi as per this fest stands for Making of Developed India. Making of Developed India. And the theme was Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, which means inclusive governance, inclusive development. Indian origin person Leo Varadkar, he is the leader of Fine Gael party, and very soon he will be elected as the Prime Minister of which country? He is going to be elected as the Prime Minister of which country? He is also openly gay. He belongs to LGBT community, and he will be the Prime Minister of Ireland. Now Ireland's capital is Dublin, and Ireland's currency is Euro. One more thing, although they won't ask it, most probably, he has a nickname also, which is called Taoiseach. Taoiseach. Which Indian lawyer has been appointed to lead the United Nations probe on alleged atrocities against Myanmar's Rohingya Muslims? So this is quite unfortunate that Myanmar, there is a genocide that is going on, and the word genocide is not used by me, it is used by United Nations itself. Rohingya Muslims are being butchered. This is called ethnic cleansing. So ethnic cleansing of Rohingya Muslims is going on in Myanmar by the Buddhist majority. And United Nations probe will be there, and Indian lawyer has been appointed to lead it. Her name is Indra Jaisingh. She's right here. And United Nations Secretary General right now is Antonio Guterres, who is from Portugal. He also met Narendra Modi ji recently. And United Nations headquarters is at New York. As per Niti Aayog, India's economy is expected to grow at what percent in the fiscal ending in March 2018? That means financial year 2018. From 1st of April 2017 to 31st March 2018, that is called financial year or fiscal. So in current fiscal, we will grow by what percent as per Niti Aayog? We will grow by a healthy 7.5%. And please keep in mind that Niti Aayog is the new name of Planning Commission of India. And Niti Aayog's chairman is always the Prime Minister. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi, courtesy ex officio, is the chairman of Niti Aayog. And vice chairman of Niti Aayog is Arvind Pangaria, economist Arvind Pangaria. And the CEO or chief executive officer is Mr. Amitabh Kant. These are the important people of Niti Aayog. So we will grow by 7.5%. Please also note that in 2018-19, that is financial year 2019, next fiscal, we will grow by 8%. This might be over optimistic, but they have said we will grow by 8%. President Pranab Mukherjee recently received the first copy of the book Lalan Shah Fakir Ke Geet. Now Lalan Shah Fakir is one of the saints, one of the mystics, and on his life, his some of the poems and preachings, they have been included in this book. It has been written by which person? These books are written by ex-India's ambassador to Bangladesh, Muchkan Dubey. Muchkan Dubey has written it, and he was India's ambassador to Bangladesh. Better word is High Commissioner, because Bangladesh is also a Commonwealth country. So India's High Commissioner to Bangladesh. Alexander Vucic, he has been sworn in as the new president of which country? So let me give you some hints. I will not tell the name directly. Capital of this country is Belgrade. This country has a very, very famous tennis player. His name is Novak Djokovic. Very, very legendary tennis player, Novak Djokovic. So this country is Serbia. And the currency of Serbia is Serbian dinar. It's a European country. Shivraj passed away. He was a veteran. So he was a character actor. This is a very easy question. He was a character actor. Which country's army chief recently announced to allow women in combat roles? So this is really a paradigm shift, and this is India, and India's army chief is Bipin Rawat, who has been in news for, both right and wrong reasons. Anyways, also note that, currently the women are allowed only in the medical, legal, educational, signal and engineering wings of the army. But now they will be in the combat roles also. And last year, Indian Air Force had inducted three brave women as fighter pilot. So now even Indian Army is following suit, and they have also announced to allow women in the combat roles. United Nations Security Council recently increased sanctions on which country? Sanctions. United Nations Security Council, it has 5 permanent members. And those 5 permanent members are France, America, USA, that is, China, then Russia, and UK. These are the 5 permanent members of the United Nations Security Council. Now you have to tell me, it increased sanctions on which country? This country is North Korea. Now North Korea is testing a lot of missiles. Basically, North Korea wants to build a ICBM, Intercontinental Ballistic Missile, so that it can scare United States. Because right now, whatever missiles North Korea has, they are not sufficient to travel to US. So Pyongyang is the capital of North Korea. And North Korea is ruled by a dictator who is called Kim Jong-un from the Jong dynasty. And basically, his grandfather Kim Jong Senior, Kim Jong-sung was his name. He was the founder of modern North Korea. And then his son Kim Jong-il, and then his son Kim Jong-un. So Kim Jong-un right now is the dictator of North Korea. And North Korea's currency is won, WON. And this is the name of the currency of South Korea also. But South Korea's capital is Seoul, not Pyongyang. Which team has failed to qualify for the Champions Trophy for the first time? So Champions Trophy, India beat Pakistan. You must have seen that game. And West Indies has failed to qualify for Champions Trophy for the first time. And West Indies, they won Champions Trophy in 2004. Who recently resigned from the committee of administrators set up by the Supreme Court to supervise the Board of Control for Cricket in India, that is BCCI? This is a good question. So after Loda Committee recommendation, this decision was taken by the Honorary Supreme Court. There was a lot of corruption and BCCI was turned upside down. There was a committee of four members who needed to administer BCCI, and these were the four members: Ramchandra Guha, Diana Adulji, Vikram Limai, and Vinod Rai. And Vinod Rai was made the head. Vinod Rai is the ex-Comptroller and Auditor General of India. He is also the Chief of Banks Board Bureau. Now, Ramchandra Guha has resigned. He is a very famous historian and he has written a lot of important books like India After Gandhi and very, very famous books. Ramchandra Guha. Which cricketer recently broke Virat Kohli's record to become world's fastest batsman to reach 7,000 one-day runs? So, he is a legendary batsman from South Africa. His name is Hashim Amla. So, Virat Kohli had taken 161 innings to make 7,000 runs. And Hashim Amla has taken just 151 matches to reach 7,000 runs. Which city's metro corporation has tied up with Google Maps? This decision has been taken by Mumbai Metro, so that Google Maps can give better geographic details and, you know, authentic timetable. So Mumbai Metro has tied up with. And please note that Metro does not come under Ministry of Railways. It comes under Ministry of Urban Development. And our Minister of Urban Development and Poverty Alleviation is Venkaiah Naidu. And Venkaiah Naidu is also the Union Minister for Information Broadcasting right now. Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, May 2017 is going to be held at which place? It will be in Astana. Astana is capital of Kazakhstan. And Tashkent is capital of Uzbekistan. Right? Dushanbe and Bishkek. Can you tell me Dushanbe and Bishkek, they are capital of which country? Because these are often very confusing. So Dushanbe and Bishkek are capitals of which country? This is your first question for you today. Now, important thing about Shanghai Cooperation Organization to note is that it was founded in 2001. And in 2015, India and Pakistan became its permanent member. Previously, India and Pakistan both were not its member. It's a Chinese-dominated organization, Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank meet is going to be held where this time? It will be held in South Korea. Now, there are a lot of things that you should know about in Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, which is that Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, largest share is of China, of course, because it is China-founded bank. And second largest shareholder is India. That is what you should know. Third is Russia and fourth is Germany. These are the four, and it's a Chinese-dominated bank. Headquarter is in Beijing. And this bank was founded in December 2015 and it started functioning in January 2016 by China, because China wanted a bank in which it can dominate, because Asian Development Bank is dominated by Japan and US, and then World Bank and International Monetary Fund are also dominated by US and European Union. So that is why AIIB was founded. And the president of AIIB is Mr. Jin Liken. And please note that Jin Liken is the ex-finance minister of China. So these are the things that you should know. Anil Ambani has announced to call the Reliance Communications and Aircel merger. What? What is the name given to the merger? So there is something known as merger and there is something known as acquisition. Merger means when the two companies of equal stature, they usually merge, and the new company that is formed usually has the name of both the companies. Merger is always, it is not hostile. It is always friendly. Both the parties should agree. Now there is something known as acquisition, where a big company, big fish eats up a small fish. That is called acquisition. Acquisition can be hostile also. So Reliance Communication is already in a loss. It has a 42,000 crore debt which it has to pay. And now it is merging with Aircel. The combined entity will be called Aircom. Aircom. So that's all you need to know. T20 Global League has been launched by which cricket governing body? Just like in India, we have Indian Premier League IPL. And it was won by Mumbai this time for a record third time. T20 Global League is a cricket league of Cricket South Africa. Cricket South Africa, 8 teams will play in T20 Global League. And also note that Mr. Chris Nanzani, he is the president of Cricket South Africa. My second question for you today: who is the president of BCCI right now? Write down in comments. Who has been appointed as public policy fellow to Wilson Center Asia program on a project on the India-Chinese ties? India-China ties, India has a, account deficit with China. So China has a trade surplus of almost $50 billion within India. So things will be discussed on a lot of India-China ties. And for that one person has been appointed. Her name is Nirupama Rao. Nirupama Rao. How many new species of plants and animals have been discovered in 2016 as per the reports by the Botanical Survey of India and Zoological Survey of India? So botany is the study of plants and zoology is the study of animals. Total number of plants and animals together is 499. So the answer is 499. But in case they are separate, you should know total 313 animals are discovered as said by Zoological Survey of India. And please note that Zoological Survey of India director is Mr. Kailash Chandar. Kailash Chandar is the director of Zoological Survey of India, and 313 animals were discovered, and 186 plants were discovered. So if you add both of these, it becomes 499. And this was announced by the Botanical Survey of India, and the director of Botanical Survey of India is Mr. Paramjit Singh. June the 1st is observed every year by the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations as what? What is June the 1st? It is World Milk Day. Very, very important. Milk is central to our nutritional requirements, and the Food and Agriculture Organization is headquartered in Rome, which is the capital of Italy. And it was first celebrated in the year 2001. This time the theme was Raise a Glass. When I say raise a glass, it is not raise a glass of wine, it is raise a glass of milk. There are three new websites or three new portals that have been launched by DOPT to access the integrity and performance levels of officer. Which of the following is not one of those? The three portals, one is called Probity. Probity is for monitoring the rotation of officers on sensitive and non-sensitive post. Then we have Sparrow. Sparrow, there is a full form of Sparrow, long full form, which is Smart Performance Appraisal Report Recording Online Window. In short, Sparrow. And then you have Solve. Solve is basically a system for online vigilance inquiry. Again, a full form is there for board level appointees. That is called Solve. So scrutiny is not there. So Solve, Probity and Sparrow. Which city has become the first to have only women manage all public parking lot under a smart parking system? This smart parking system, till 9 p.m. in the night, women will operate it. It will be operated by just the females in Chandigarh. Chandigarh is the capital of both Haryana and Punjab. It is a union territory. It is a union territory. And you know that any union territory is administered by a lieutenant governor. So VP Singh Badnor, who is the he is the administrator of Chandigarh and he is the governor of Punjab. As per the Minister of State for Civil Aviation, Jayant Sinha, please note, in the Ministry of Civil Aviation, we have the union minister. His name is Ashok Gajapati Raju, but we also have a Minister of State who helps him out. His name is Jayant Sinha. Jayant Sinha, he is the son of Yashwant Sinha. So how is India ranked in the world in terms of passenger traffic size? Passenger traffic size. So last year, in 2016-17, 10 crore people in India, they took flights. So we are third in the world in terms of traffic. And also note that in last year, 2016-17, the prices of air tickets in India, median airfare, they fell by 18%. They reduced by 18%. June 6 has been dedicated to celebrate which of the six official languages of United Nations. So which are the six official languages of United Nations? One is Chinese. Okay, I'm writing here. Then you have Spanish. Then you have Arabic, then you have Russian, then you have English, and then you have French. These are the six languages. Now let me tell you which are the official days to celebrate. Chinese language is celebrated on April the 20th. Very, very important. Spanish on April 23rd. But that's not it. English also on April 23rd. So April 23rd, we celebrate two languages, Spanish and English, and Chinese on April 20th. Then we have Arabic, which is celebrated on December the 18th. And then we have Russian, which is the answer of this question. So Russian is celebrated on June the 6th. And that is why this question, because it happened in the first week of June. And French is on March the 20th. 20th March. So these six languages you should know. A pilot of five electronic taxis has been launched in Hyderabad. And they will be operated by which company? See, pilot project is something that you do on a small scale before implementing it or extrapolating it on a very large area. So it's always better to implement a policy at the smaller level to see how it works and how it goes. That is called a pilot project. So five electronic taxis, they are operated by a company called Green Mile. And you know, our central government, it has committed to make Indian transport electrical and non-polluting by the year 2030. That is the target. And also India is a party to the COP21 Paris Agreement. So that is legally binding on India. And therefore, India needs to make sure that its emissions are kept to a minimum. Which bank has entered into a memorandum of understanding with Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium? That is called SFAC. Which bank is that? It is Bank of Baroda. Bank of Baroda, which is headquartered in Vadodara in Gujarat. And P.S. Jayakumar is the managing director and CEO of this bank. P.S. Jayakumar. Now, please note that this tie-up has been done to provide collateral free loans to farmer. Collateral means when a farmer has to keep something with the bank to take the loan as a guarantee. That is called collateral. Now they don't have to keep the collateral. And there is a credit guarantee cover up to 85% of the loan amount, maximum up to rupees 1 crore, will be made available by the Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium. And our agriculture minister is Radha Mohan Singh. What is India's rank on the Global Peace Index? Are we a very peaceful country? So 70% of Indian population lives in areas which are marked by any sort of insurgency. Be it Kashmir, we have the different kind of militancy there. We have in Northeast and some of these areas, we have different kind of insurgency. 70% of India is affected with any kind of insurgency. So we are definitely not a very peaceful country. The most peaceful country in the world, which was first in the rankings, is Iceland. And Iceland capital is Reykjavik. And second most peaceful country in the world is New Zealand. Its capital is Wellington. And the third most peaceful country in the world is Portugal. Capital is Lisbon. We are way behind 137. And the last country, 163rd, was Syria. Capital is Damascus. Syria, you know, there's a civil war going on. And also there is a United States and Russia proxy war going on. Syria's president is Bashar al-Assad. And Russia is supporting Bashar al-Assad. Whereas America is supporting the rebels who want to overthrow the established regime. Which state has launched its official digital wallet, which is called T-Wallet? Now, T here stands for Telangana. And Telangana is the latest state, 29th state of India. Telangana's capital is Hyderabad. Telangana's governor is Mr. Narasimha. And he is also the governor of Andhra. So his name is Mr. Narasimha. And please note that Telangana is ruled by Telangana Rashtri Samiti, which is headed by Chief Minister Chandrasekhar Rao. And this wallet, if you use, there will be no transaction fee that you have to pay. And if you don't have a mobile phone, then also you can use it by Mi Seva Kendra, Mi Seva Center. Total 4,000 centers have been opened across Telangana. And this these platforms, this wallet will be supported in Telugu, Urdu and English. So, and one more question they can ask, which company is supporting this platform? They are using Microsoft Azure platform. Microsoft Azure. United Nations World Oceans Conference is being held where? This is a direct question. This is a 5-day conference and it is co-hosted by the government of Fiji and Sweden. And it is being held in New York in America. Fiji's capital is Suva. Sweden's capital is Stockholm. What was India's GDP growth rate in the fourth quarter of last fiscal? That is from 1st of January 2017 to 31st March 2017, our GDP growth was a very, very poor 6.1%. And China grew 6.9%. This was all because of demonetization. So the government's submission that GDP will grow more because of demonetization and all this fell flat. We grew only 6.1%. Economy completely collapsed in the fourth quarter of last fiscal. DOPT has amended the Central Civil Service Rules 1965, and it has set a deadline of how many months to complete the probe in corruption cases involving government employees. So the thing is, let's say you catch a government employee in corruption. Okay, now the cases used to run for years and years. As per a study, average time taken is 2 years, with a maximum time in one case that was 8 years. So average time is 2 years for any probe investigation in the corruption cases involving government employees. Now there is a deadline which has been kept for 180 days or 6 months by the DOPT. Aadhaar card has been made compulsory for availing the benefit of which scheme? Now Aadhaar card has been made mandatory for two things. One is if you want to avail kerosene subsidy, then you need Aadhaar card, kerosene subsidy, and also for Atal Pension Yojana. Atal Pension Yojana, which is for the age group of 18 to 40. Which Indian celebrity has joined UNICEF's campaign Super Dad as an ambassador? Super Dad. It is to spread awareness about various efforts and the critical role that fathers play in our upbringing and all. So UNICEF is headquartered in New York, the same place where we have the headquarters of United Nations. And UNICEF is an agency of United Nations which works for children. United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund, UNICEF. And the celebrity is Sachin Tendulkar. Now my third question for you today, and it is a difficult question. Now you know that there is a biopic, there is a movie made on the life of Sachin Tendulkar, and it has been directed by not an Indian but a foreigner. Who is the director of the movie Sachin, which was launched last week? Write down in comment. It's a slightly difficult question. T.S.V. Hari, he passed away. He was a famous what? T.S.V. Hari. So he was basically journalist, also scriptwriter and columnist. So he was all of the above. Now, he used to write satire for the magazine called Tughlaq. and he was former IANS bureau chief also, and he had converted B.R. Chopra's Mahabharata epic into Tamil also. So he was a lot of things. He was a journalist, scripter, columnist, all of the above. National Board of Wildlife. It has given its approval for Defense Research Development's organization's long range missile test facility at which island in Andaman. DRDO is very important for us because it is Defense Research Development Organization. It comes up with a lot of important paraphernalia and armamentarium for our defense forces. And DRDO is headed by Mr. Christopher. Mr. S. Christopher is the chief of DRDO right now. And ISRO's chief is AS Kiran Kumar. Now please note that this particular wildlife park is in Andaman and its name is Rutland Island. Rutland Island. Now there is a Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park in Andaman. Okay. It is in 48 acres of eco-sensitive zone. So they have to divert 1 acre of area for missile test facility. Who is the governor of Andaman? You know that Andaman Nicobar is a union territory and union territory is administered by a lieutenant governor. So the lieutenant governor of Andaman is Mr. Jagdish Mukhi. Bharti Airtel and Telenor. Telenor, the Nor stands for Norway. It is a company of telecom company of Norway. Now Bharti Airtel and Telenor, they have received the approval from which of the following for their merger? They are getting merged. For that they have got approval from SEBI, BSE, and NSE, all the three. That is SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, and SEBI is the capital market regulator. BSE is Bombay Stock Exchange. It is the oldest stock exchange of not only India but Asia. National Stock Exchange is the highest valued stock exchange in India. It has got permission from all the three, but it has yet to get permission from NCLT, which is National Company Law Tribunal, and also from CCI, which is the Competition Commission of India. And Competition Commission of India, anything more than 5,000 crore, you have to go to Competition Commission of India. Nitin Seth recently resigned from his position of Chief Operating Officer of which company? This company CEO is Mr. Kalyan Krishnamurthy, and founders were Sachin Bansal and Benny Bansal. So this company is Flipkart, headquartered in Bengaluru. Rain Harvesting Festival, which is called Mazakkoyathul Savam, was recently celebrated in which state? It is a rain harvesting festival of Kerala. And in this festival, basically, there are 13,000 schools in Kerala in which there are, you know, pits that are being dug so that water can be filled up in these pits and we can save the water. Now, Kerala is run by a very efficient CPIM government and Chief Minister is Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan. Kerala is also the first digital state of India. First digital state. And its governor is the retired Justice P. Satashivam. P. Satashivam is the governor of Kerala. Which state government has come up with a green protocol to make wedding ceremony in the state friendly? So again, we have seen time and again that these wedding ceremony, they have like, lush spending and I mean, good for nothing, and they are not environment friendly. So which state government has come up with a green protocol for weddings now? This has been again done by Kerala. And there was a mission that was launched in Kerala, which is called Suchitva Mission. This is regarding sanitation, and Suchitva Mission has become now the nodal agency for the sanitation. Which country is going to launch its first satellite into space? That is called Mazalai. This is the first satellite of this country, Mazalai. This will be done by a country with which we do a defense military exercise, which is called Nomadic Elephant. So this is of course Mongolia. The capital of Mongolia is Ulaanbaatar. And name the currency of Mongolia, it is Togrog. And this is very, very important, Togrog. And this is basically, Mazalai is named after Mongolian Gobi beer. See, Gobi is the name of a desert in Mongolia, Gobi desert. It is a cold desert, it is not a hot desert. And this satellite will accompany SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. Falcon 9, which is a rocket of SpaceX, both will go together. MITS Mega Food Park was recently inaugurated by the Union Minister for Food Processing Industries, Harsimrat Kaur Badal. Harsimrat Kaur Badal is from Shiromani Akali Dal. She is a Union Minister for Food Processing Industries. In which state? So this actually is a mega food park in a district called Rayagada. Rayagada is in Odisha. Now don't confuse Rayagada with Raigad. Raigad is in Chhattisgarh. So there is, make the distinction. And Odisha's governor, you should know. Odisha's governor is S.C. Jamir. Mr. S.C. Jamir is the J.A.M.I.R. governor of Odisha. And it is Odisha's first mega food park. And total, it is 7th mega food park that has been inaugurated in India. Who has been appointed as the vice chairman of IFCO? IFCO, you should know three important people. IFCO chairman is Mr. B.K. Nakai, the first option. And ISCO also has another important person. His name is U.S. Awasthi, the second option. He is the managing director of IFCO. And vice chairman is Vithal Rardia. Union Urban Development Minister Venkaiya Naidu recently launched Municipal Solid Waste Segregation Program in which place? Basically, there are special vehicles now which are meant to collect the segregated garbage. And the garbage we will segregate, we will separate. Like for example, there is a wet garbage and there is a dry waste. So wet we will put in the green bucket. You can see green bucket here. And there is a blue bucket also which is for dry waste. We will separate the two. And there will be separate vehicles also which will carry the segregated garbage. This program was launched in New Delhi. New Delhi's governor is Anil Baijal and New Delhi's chief minister is Kejriwal. Which union ministry launched Inam Pro Plus? It is an e-commerce platform for buyers and sellers. Inam Pro Plus. And this is basically an updated version of Inam, which was a scheme that was launched in 2015. It did sales of around 32 crore rupees in 2 years. So this is by Road Transport and Highway, and our minister for the same is Nitin Gadkari. G. Parameshwara, he recently resigned from the post of Home Minister of which state? Home Minister is said to be the second most powerful post in any state after the Chief Minister. He was the Chief Minister of Karnataka, which has a Congress government, and Chief Minister is Siddaramaiah. And Governor of Karnataka is Vajubhai Wala. Who has become the first Indian woman to climb Mount Everest from the China side? So, and not only this, in the past she has also climbed Mount Everest from the Nepal side also. In Nepal, Mount Everest is called Sagar Mat. And Mount Everest height is 8,848 meter, which is like highest in the world, and it is still growing. If you believe the geographical theories, it is still growing. The name of this Indian woman is Anita Kundu. She has climbed Mount Everest from China side, and in 2013 she had also climbed Mount Everest from the Nepal side. And Anshu Jamna Senpa, she met Narendra Modi ji recently, Prime Minister recently. She was accompanied by Kiran Rijiju also. She has climbed Mount Everest 2 times in 5 days. She is from Arunachal Pradesh, so you know she is also very very important for MCQs. Which of the following companies launched Green Thumb? Green Thumb is basically they want to increase the green cover. They want to plant 42,000 trees and 10,000 people will participate. It is by Tata Projects. Tata Projects has launched Green Thumb. It is like a CSR. What is the name of the second Scorpion class submarine which began its sea trials? Very very important. The first Scorpion class submarine was Kalwari and the second one is Khanderi. And our Navy chief right now is Mr. Sunil Lamba. Which Indian personality has been re-elected as a board of director in the International Table Tennis Federation to represent Asia? Do you know where are the headquarters of International Table Tennis Federation? So can you tell me where is the headquarter of ITTF? That is your fourth question for it today. And he will represent Asia. His name is Dhanraj Chaudhary. Who has taken over as the chairman of Indian Oil Corporation? See, Indian Oil Corporation, it is a Maharatan company, one of the biggest public sector undertakings of India, PSUs. Please also note, it is the most profitable company of India, government company of India. It overtook ONGC, it leapfrogged ONGC as the most profitable company. And our oil minister is Dharmendra Pradhan. And who is the chairman of Indian Oil Corporation? So, he has replaced Mr. B. Ashok. His name is Sanjeev Singh. Sanjeev Singh is the new chairman of Indian Oil Corporation. Which Indian tennis player won ITF men's future title which was held in Singapore? This is very important. It is the first title of this season and fifth title of his career. He beat a USA player called Mr. Raymond. His name is Ramakumar Ramanathan. Which security force has partnered with the National Skill Development Corporation of India for starting training programs for the retired security officers, retired security personnel? It has been done by Central Industrial Security Force, which is CISF. Who is the CISF head right now? Mr. O.P. Singh. General O.P. Singh is the secretary, director general of CISF. And who is the minister for skill development and entrepreneurship? Rajiv Pratap Rudi is the minister for skill development and entrepreneurship. Which of the following received the prestigious APQN Asia Pacific Quality, APQN stands for Asia Pacific Quality Network Award 2017 for International Cooperation in Quality Assurance. This award has been bestowed upon National Assessment and Accreditation Council. Now, please note that National Accreditation and Assessment and Accreditation Council headquartered at Bengaluru, and this ceremony was held in Moscow. S. Abdul Rahman, he passed away. He was a famous what? He was very, very famous poet, and he was popularly known as Kavikko, K-A-V-I-K-K-O, Kavikko. He was also a recipient of the prestigious Sahitya Academy Award in 1999 for his collection of poems, which is called Alapanai, and he was from Tamil Nadu. Which university in India, along with India Post, released commemorative stamps on five Indian writers? Now, these five Indian writers are Balwant Gargi, Bhisham Sahani, Krishan Chandar, Sharilal Shukla, and K.V. Putappa. You don't need to remember the name. Just remember the name of the university. It is Punjab University. Which bank has announced to set up 100 digital villages across the country? Please note that the first digital village in India was the Akodra village. It is in Sabarkantha district in Gujarat. It was made digital by ICICI Bank. Now, which bank has recently announced to make 100 more digital villages in India? It is the Vijaya Bank, which is headquartered in Bengaluru. It is a bank from Karnataka. And Vijaya Bank, its managing director and CEO is Dr. Kishore Sansi, S-A-N-S-I, Dr. Kishore Sansi. India successfully test-fired, indigenously developed, so made in India, quick reaction, surface-to-air short-range missile at the integrated test range ITR at Chandipur in Odisha. Now, please note that there is an island also there, which is called the Wheeler Island. And the new name of Wheeler Island is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Island. What is the range of this missile? It is a very, very short range missile. It is 30 kilometers. It is jointly built by Defense Research Development Organization and BEL, that is Bharat Electronics Limited. World's first wind farm powered by giant kites. You can see one of the kites here. Very, very giant kite. And it is going to be built where? It will be built in UK. UK Prime Minister is Theresa May. Total, there will be 20 kites that will fly at a rate of 100 miles per hour. So the energy that will be generated will be converted to electricity. Which IIT in India has devised a technology that can be fitted in an ambulance to ensure remote monitoring of patients by the doctors? So this is like a telemedicine, not exactly telemedicine. Doctors are not able to reach to the rural folklore, but now it will be possible. It will be made possible by this technology devised by IIT Kharagpur. And this ambulance has been called AmbuSense, A-M-B-U-S-E-N-S. What is India's rank on the 2017 Global Retail Development Index that ranks 30 developing countries? And it was released by A.T. Kearney. We are number one. And second is China. China's president is Xi Jinping. China recently organized Belt and Road Forum, which is their One Belt, One Road initiative. String of pearls strategy India did not participate. Indian Meteorological Department, IMD. Now, IMD Director General is Mr. K.J. Ramesh. So, Indian Meteorological Department has announced that it is developing a system in order to be able to give alerts on the outbreak of diseases at a notice of how many days. This is because prevention is better than cure. So, this is 15 days. And that's all you need to know. Yeah, IMD has a National Climate Center in Pune that will be reorganized. That announcement was also done. In which city was India's first public bicycle sharing initiative, which is called Trin Trin? So Trin Trin is basically the sound when we use the when we honk our bicycles. That is the sound Trin Trin. So India's first public bicycle sharing, and more than 450 bicycles will be shared in Mysuru in Karnataka. Now please also note that Mysuru till recently was the cleanest city of India. Mysuru lost that tag to Indore this year in the Clean India campaign ranking, Swachhta Abhiyan, Swachh Bharat rankings. How many memorandum of understanding has India signed up with Spain? We signed it with the Prime Minister of Spain, and he is Mariano Rajoy. This gentleman here, Spain's capital is Madrid. How many MOUs we signed with Spain? Total, we signed 7 MOUs with Spain, like in cybersecurity, renewable energy, organ transplantation also, civil aviation, diplomatic service, prisoner exchange, and waiving of visas. With Germany, we signed 12 pacts. So Modi was on a visit to 4 countries. Who was recently appointed as executive director by the Reserve Bank of India? By the way, Reserve Bank of India, just yesterday, on 7th of June, it has given its second bi-monthly monetary policy. That is the second monetary policy for this fiscal. And Governor is Urjit Patel. They have not made any changes to the repo rate, which is very surprising because you know, we are growing at only 6.1%. We grew by only 6.1%. So there was a need to increase the growth. And when we want to increase the growth, we need to cut the repo rate, but they have kept it constant. In fact, all the rates have been kept constant except SLR, statutory liquidity ratio, in which there is a 50 basis points cut. That's all. So it has been criticized by the government that RBI is not doing enough to promote growth in India. Insofar as this question is concerned, Executive Director is Ganesh Kumar. Which state's High Court recently ruled against the encroachments in the ridge areas? Encroachment means when we take into our possession something that is not ours. So there are land encroachments in the ridge area. For that, there has been ruling by the Delhi High Court. And Delhi High Court Chief Justice is Geeta Mittal. But Geeta Mittal is the acting Chief Justice before they find a permanent Chief Justice. Which country recently repealed a 334 years old blasphemy law that forbids public insult of a religion? So blasphemy means profanity. When you insult anything that is holy, that is considered sacred. Now there is a 334 year old antediluvian law that you can't insult a religion in public. I mean, so that has been done away with for good. It has made way for better laws in Denmark. Denmark is a Scandinavian country. Capital is Copenhagen. Which of the following persons recently resigned from his post of vice chairman and a member of the board of National Stock Exchange? And he was also one of the founding members of National Stock Exchange. His name is Ravi Narayan. Ravi Narayan. Now, there is a handbook on the protection of child rights at Gram Panchayat level. It was released jointly by the NCPCR. What is NCPCR? It is the National Commission for Protection of Child Rights and Ministry of Panchayati Raj and UNICEF. Who is the Minister of State for Panchayati Raj in India? His name is Parsottam Bhai Rupala. Parsottam Bhai Rupala. And NCPCR, that is National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, chairman is Shrimati Stuti Kakkar. Stuti Kakkar is the chairman of NCPCR. As per the World Bank's Global Economic Prospects report, what is the forecast of global growth in 2017? In 2017, global growth will be 2.7%. And in 2018, it will be 2.9%. And also, advanced economic growth will be 1.9%. And emerging markets growth will be 4.1%. Now, World Bank's CEO is Kristina Georgieva. Kristina Georgieva. And the president of World Bank is Jim Yong Kim. As per the Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation, which is headquartered in London, India's economic growth is expected to remain flat in this current fiscal at what percent? In this current fiscal, we will grow at 7.1% as per the Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation. Which state in India has joined hands with UK to impart skill development and technical education to the youth? This decision has been taken by the Technical Education Minister Charanjit Singh Chanani of Punjab. It has a Congress government. Captain Amrinder Singh is the Chief Minister and Governor is VP Singh Badnor. Which state won 3 awards in implementing the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act scheme, which gives you a job guarantee of certain number of days every year? So this state is West Bengal. West Bengal. And who is our Minister for Rural Development? Narendra Singh Tomar. Narendra Singh Tomar is the Minister for Rural Development. And our Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment is Mr. Bandaru Dattatreya. So you should know all the union ministers. And who is the Governor of Bengal? K.N. Tripathi. Kesari Nath Tripathi. And who is the CM of Bengal? The famous, or rather infamous, Mamata Banerjee of the Trinamool Congress. What is the name of the Indian-American girl who won the 90th Scripps National Spelling Bee? In fact, these spelling competitions are very, very good to watch also. And more often than not, it's an Indian that comes on top every time. So this time it was won by Ananya Vinay. And please also note that there is another girl that can be asked in exam. Her name is Raksha Gopal. Now, Raksha Gopal is CBSE topper in 12th class. She scored 99.96%. 99.6%, yeah, not 96, 99.6% in CBSE class 12. She's from Amity School in Noida. Paramjit Mann has been appointed as the next ambassador of India to which country? Now, this country's capital is Ljubljana. In fact, it is pronounced as Ljubljana, but just for writing, Ljubljana. So, this country is Slovenia, and currency of this country is Euro. Which Olympic athlete has won the gold medal in the women's 3000 meter steeplechase in the Federation Cup Athletics that was held in Patiala in Punjab? Steeplechase, women's 3000 meter. She also had qualified for the Olympics, which was a very big achievement. Her name is Sudha Singh. Now you should know one or two people more. There is a person from Haryana, Naveen Kumar. He is also steeplechaser. He won the event in the men's section. Naveen Kumar. And Sudha Singh is from Uttar Pradesh. Then there is B. Chetan of Karnataka. B. Chetan of Karnataka, he won the men's high jump. By the way, this time UPSC topper is also from Karnataka, Nandini. Then you have men's 20 kilometer walk. That was won by Mr. Sandeep Kumar. Which space agency is going to launch a sounding rocket which will release blue, green and red artificial clouds to study ionosphere and aurora? This will be done by NASA, which is the space agency of America. It is headquartered in Washington, D.C. NASA. It will release some blue, green and red artificial clouds. Which Bollywood actor has been appointed by the Wildlife Trust of India as the brand ambassador? She was also ex-Miss Asia Pacific. Her name is Dia Mirza. Writer Juan Goytisolo. He passed away. He was from where? He was a very famous writer. And he had also won the Cervantes Prize. Cervantes Prize. It is called the Spanish Nobel Prize in the year 2014. So he was from Spain. Which of the following is going to introduce the buy now and pay later scheme? This scheme will be by Indian Railways. You have to pay within next 14 days or 2 weeks. And you will have to pay a service charge of 3.5%. Indian Railways, our railway minister is Suresh Prabhu. And for this, for implementing this scheme, Indian Railways has partnered with a company which is called ePayLater. The name of the company is ePayLater. It is headquartered in Mumbai. And it has partnered with IRCTC, which is Indian Railways Catering and Tourism Corporation. India recently conducted successful test fire of which indigenously developed nuclear capable missile at Chandipur test range, again in Odisha. The name of this missile is Prithvi the Second. It was first test fired in 1996. Then it was inducted into the Indian Armed Forces in 2003. Made by again DRDO and Bharat Dynamics Limited. Which of the following recently launched its international exchange in the GIFT City, that is the Gujarat International Finance Tech City? Recently, NSE opened their International Stock Exchange. And BSE has already done it in GIFT City. Already. Which bank has announced that it has commissioned over 200 ATMs which are powered by solar energy? So solar powered ATMs in the last 1 year, more than 200, they have been commissioned by which bank? This bank is the largest private bank in India, ICICI Bank. President is Chanda Kochar. Who is leading the Indian delegation at the second Mission Innovation Ministerial and 8th Energy Clean Energy Ministerial, which will be held in Beijing in China. So don't get confused by energy, because our Minister for Renewable Energy is Piyush Goyal. He is our Minister for Coal, Electricity and Renewable Energy. But this time Indian delegation will be headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. Now, let me tell you about Dr. Harshvardhan. He is the Minister for Earth Sciences, Science and Technology. He is also given additional charge of the Ministry of Environment after Anil Madhav Dave passed away two weeks back. So Dr. Harshvardhan right now is Science and Technology Minister also, Minister for Earth Sciences, and given additional charge of Ministry for Environment. United Nations Security Council recently elected how many non-permanent member for a two-year term? So United Nations Security Council, you should know about it, that it has 10 elected member and five permanent members. Five permanent member, I've already told you which are the five permanent members, and five non-permanent members have been elected. Their names are Ivory Coast, Equatorial Guinea, Kuwait, Poland and Peru. These are the five new member, and you should know all the five. I repeat, Ivory Coast, Equatorial Guinea or Guinea, Kuwait, Poland and Peru. And therefore, since the five members are new elected, so five members should make way also. That is, five seats need to be vacated also. So which countries have vacated the post? Egypt, Japan, Senegal, Ukraine and Uruguay. These are the five which have vacated the seats. As per a study by KPMG, which football club has become the most valuable in Europe? It is the richest football club in Europe. So it is Manchester United, which is based in Manchester, which is in England. And second richest club is Real Madrid, which won the UEFA Champions League. Now the coach of Manchester United is Jose Mourinho. He is from Portugal. Securities and Exchange Board of India recently banned or barred which of the following from acting as investment advisor and research analyst? They have banned Cyprus Money because they were doing unauthorized trading. And SEBI's chairman is very frequent question, SEBI CEO, which is Mr. Ajay Tyagi. This is a very frequent question which is asked in Bank PO exam. Ajay Tyagi. Which country has recently launched a satellite system which is called Michibiki? Michibiki. This is their own GPS system. Just like India launched their own GPS system 2 weeks back. This has been done by JAXA, which is Japanese Aeronautical Exploration Agency, which is the space agency of Japan. What is the name? Michibiki. As per a survey by National Tiger Conservation Authority, NTCA, which tiger reserve has highest density of tigers in India? See, tiger, you know, the first effort was the Jim Corbett National Park in India, which was the first tiger national park. By the way, India has 70% of the population of tigers of the world. And highest tiger density is in Orang. Orang Tiger Reserve, it is in Assam. It is very, very small. But even though it is very small, it has lot of tigers. In fact, it has 28 tigers. So that means tiger density is very, very large. It is the highest in India. It is in Assam. Assam also has Manas National Park, Kaziranga National Park, and lot of national park. Defense Acquisition Council, DAC, has decided to cancel Army's global contest for SRSAM system. What is SRSAM? Do you have any idea about that? So SR means short range and SAM means surface to air missile system. Now they are not buying it from outside. We are not doing any global contest for that. We will use our own made in India missile. What is that missile? This missile is called Akash, surface to air missile. And Defense Acquisition Council chairman is the defense minister, who is right now Arun Jaitley. Manohar Parikar is not the defense minister right now, because he became the chief minister of Goa once again. A travel ban on which country has been imposed by the Middle Eastern countries for allegedly supporting terrorism? So this is what you call, you know, there is a saying in English which is called, it is the pot calling the kettle black. Saudi Arabia, it has been funding the Wahhabi and Salafi philosophy across the world. It has been supporting terrorism, and now Saudi Arabia led consortium, they boycotted Qatar. So I mean, all is happening, and this is a wonderful video made by our faculty Prashant. Do check that video out. And Saudi Arabia, UAE, Egypt and Bahrain, they have all boycotted Qatar. What is the 2017 theme for World Environment Day, which was observed on June the 5th? This is one of the most important questions. 5th June is observed as World Environment Day. This time the theme was connecting people to nature. Connecting people to nature. And please note that the 2017 host country was Canada. And World Environment Day has been observed since 1974. Which country has recently pulled out of Paris Agreement on climate change? I have made a video on this also. It is United States of America. They believe that it is unfair to, Donald Trump believes it is unfair to America. America has to pledge $3 billion every day to developing, every year to developing countries, and also their industries will be affected. USA is also one of the greatest polluters of the world. Who has been appointed as the CEO of Prasar Bharati? Prasar Bharati is our broadcasting platform which broadcasts Doordarshan and other channels, and he will replace Jawahar Sarkar. His name is Shashi Shekhar Vempati. Now, three new mobile apps have been launched by the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, TRAI. Which of the following is not one of them? So the first app is MyCall. MyCall is the voice quality monitoring app. This is there. Then you have MySpeed, which will test the data speed. It is there. Then you have something which is for spam detection, which is called Do Not Disturb. So My Data is the answer. It is not one of the apps launched by TRAI. Who has been elected as the president of International Table Tennis Federation? I asked you a question. Where is the headquarter of International Table Tennis Federation? It is in Lausanne in Switzerland. And Switzerland also has the headquarter in Zurich of FIFA. Switzerland also has headquartered of plenty of organizations in Geneva. So Mr. Thomas Weckart has been elected as the president. He is from Germany. Which bank in India is going to urbanize farmers meets at 15,500 rural and semi-urban branches across the country? So this branch has so many branches, 15,500. This is of course the largest lender in India, State Bank of India, which expects 10 lakh farmers to attend its initiative. Which of the following became the first Indian doubles pair to reach the last 8 in the World Table Tennis Championship? Although they got beaten in the last 8, but this was a very big feat, because in a sport like table tennis, we are nowhere in the world. And we were beaten by world number 1 and world number 2. So it's no shame in losing to them. This championship was held in Dusseldorf in Germany. The name is Manika Batra and Mahuma Das. Remember their names. Manika Batra and Mahuma Das. ISRO. ISRO, the pride of India, Indian Space Research Organization, which is headquartered in Bengaluru. And ISRO's chairman is AS Kiran Kumar. So ISRO recently launched GSLV Mark 3 rocket. It is also called Fat Boy. And I mean, they're calling it all sorts of names. Some are calling it Bahubali. And because it is very, very, I mean, very heavy actually. What is the weight? And it has been launched along with the GSAT-19 satellite. So there are nicknames like Fat Boy, Monster Rocket, some are calling it Bahubali. Its weight is a whopping 640 tons. And you know, it can lift into a space a 4,000 kilogram satellite. So that's how big it is. Which bank has become the third bank on which Reserve Bank of India has taken prompt corrective action. So prompt corrective action is of two types. One is discretionary, one is mandatory. Like it can stop the bank from opening new branches. It can do away with the director's compensation. There are a lot of things. Do check out my banking awareness video for May 2017. I've explained in depth, in detail, what is PCA. So the first bank on which PCA was done was IDBI Bank. Second bank was the UCO Bank, which is headquartered in Kolkata. Third bank now is the Dena Bank. Its non-performing assets have crossed more than 10%. Politician Era Shazian, he passed away. He was from which state? Era Shazian was a MP, Lok Sabha member of parliament in 1962. He was first elected in 1962. He was from the state of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu governor is C. Vidyasagar Rao, who is also the governor of Maharashtra, and chief minister is Edappadi Swami. Which Indian badminton player recently won the gold medal at the Thailand Grand Prix? So he's having a very good patch. And he has won, Thailand Open also, Singapore Grand Prix, and now Thailand Grand Prix. Earlier this year, he had won the Singapore Super Series also. So it is his first Grand Prix. Grand Prix is a French word, which means big prize. This indeed is a big prize, and it was won by P.B. Sai Praneet. Hi Sierra, it is the new operating system unveiled by which of the following? So I saw this event live. It is iOS 11, launched by Apple. Tim Cook is the CEO of Apple. Tim Cook. In a first time, which state has launched a pension scheme for single women? So if you are a single woman, you will be paid 1000 rupees per month by this state. And all the children of single women, they will have free education in the Telangana residential educational institutions. This decision has been taken by the government of Telangana. Which country has become the latest member of NATO? North Atlantic Treaty Organization. It is an American dominated organization. And basically, a lot of countries have aligned themselves to the US, considering it as a big daddy that will protect them from a foreign invasion. So this is like a expansionist tool for America. Anyways, so 29th member of NATO is Montenegro. Now the capital of Montenegro is Podgorica, who has been appointed as the Director General of National Water Development Agency. National Water Development Agency works under the Ministry of Water Resources Management, Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And minister for that is Uma Bharti. So who has been appointed as the Director General of National Water Development Agency? It is Mr. Sharad Kumar Jain, and he will replace S. Masood Hussain. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the Corporate Governance Committee recently constituted by SEBI? He is the Managing Director of Kotak Mahindra Bank. His name is Uday Kotak. World's fastest lift elevator is going to be installed in which country? It will be installed in China, and this elevator can, it has a speed of 1260 meter per minute. First project for rural electrification, that is rural light emitting diode, street lighting, it is going to be set up by Energy Efficiency Services Limited in which state? It will be done in the 7 districts of Andhra Pradesh, which has a, Telugu Desam Party government, Chandrababu Naidu is the chief minister, and governor is Mr. Narasimha. So Lakshmi Narasimha is the governor of both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Which company signed a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of MSME, that is Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, to open 2 more technical training schools? This decision has been taken by a South Korean company. Now out of these 4 options, 3 are American companies, 1 is South Korean. It is Samsung. Samsung, LG, Hyundai, all of these are South Korean companies. Governor KK Paul, he recently launched Vidya Virta Abhiyan in which state? Vidya means education, Virta means bravery. So, you know, all our freedom fighters and not freedom fighters, our martyrs, Paramvir Chakra winners. Paramvir Chakra is the highest bravery award in India. So their photos will be built on the walls in school so that students develop a feeling of patriotism and all that. So Vidya Virta Abhiyan was launched in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand has a recently inducted Bharatiya Janata Party government. Chief Minister is Trivendra Singh Rawat and Governor is KK Paul. KK Paul is the ex-DGP of Delhi. Which bank has recently raised 15,000 crore rupees from domestic and foreign institutional investors through the QIP of share, that is Qualified Institutional Placement of Shares? This has been done by the bank, which is State Bank of India. Of course, the largest lender in the country. International Day of Innocent Children, victims of aggression, is observed every year on which day? Innocent children who become victims of aggression, violence. For that, there is a day. This day is the 2nd of June. Sorry, 4th of June. 4th of June is the answer, not 2nd of June. And this day has been celebrated since 1982. Which space agency is going to launch the first ever mission to spinning neutron stars? This again is a mission of NASA. And there is a mission Juno also, which is for Jupiter. Appointment Committee of the Cabinet, ACC, it has extended the term of the law officers. Who is the Solicitor General of India? Solicitor General is Ranjit Kumar, and there is another very important post, which is the Attorney General. He is Mukul Rohatgi. He is Mukul Rohatgi, this right side fellow, and he is Ranjit Kumar. So both of their terms have been extended. And also we have five additional Solicitor Generals also. Pinky Anand, Paramjit Singh Patwalia, Tushar Mehta, Maninder Singh and P.S. Narasimha. Don't need to remember the name, just remember that Solicitor General is Ranjit Kumar and Mukul Rohatgi is the Attorney General. Their terms have been extended. What is India's rank in the annual competitiveness rankings compiled by the International Institute for Management Development World Competitiveness Center? I repeat. Annual competitiveness rankings compiled by the International Institute for Management Development's World Competitiveness Center. Hong Kong is number one. It is a special administrative region of China. Venezuela is last. That is 63 countries were ranked. And we are always near the bottom, not at the bottom, but near the bottom. We are 45. Which of the following recently launched its first recycled cargo ship to the International Space Station? This was done by SpaceX, which is a company of Elon Musk. And you should know the rocket SpaceX Falcon 9 and Dragon capsule. It is also associated with SpaceX. National Skill Development Corporation has partnered with which academy in India to train more than 30,000 unemployed youth because of joblessness, and they will basically train them in the aviation space. Our civil aviation minister is Ashok Gajpati Raju. This academy is the Bird Academy. Indian Army is going to induct 18 guns. They are our self-made guns, indigenously developed artillery guns by the end of year. What is the name of that gun? The guns are called Dhanush and they have a maximum range of 40 kilometers. And these are basically upgraded version of Bofors. Bofors guns we had bought from Sweden. Remember the famous Bofors camp? Which city is going to get India's first fleet village? India's first fleet village will be developed by the Inland Waterway Authority of India in Varanasi. Varanasi is the Lok Sabha constituency of Narendra Modi. Kalinga Literary Awards for this year, they have been conferred on three individuals. Which of the following is not one of them? So there is Anand Neelakantan. He is the writer of the movie Bahubali. He has been given the award, which is called Kalinga International Award. Har Prasad Das has also been given the award. He has been given Kalinga Youth Award. And Paramita Satpati, she has been given Kalinga Karubaki Award. So Rashmi Ranjan Raut is the answer. She has not been bestowed upon any award. Now Kalinga Awards are given by the UNESCO in association with Odisha government. Indian Railways is going to reduce the emissions by 33% by which year? Because India is a signatory to COP21 now. So we need to reduce our emissions. 33% Indian Railways have kept a target by 2030. Which state has recently announced a 6-point comprehensive plan for farmers? This was done because this state celebrated the statehood day, state formation day on June the 2nd. So June the 2nd, Telangana was formed. They celebrate statehood day on June the 2nd. So answer is Telangana. And 8,000 rupees cash will be given to farmers per acre per year. And this decision was announced by Chief Minister Chandrasekhar Rao. First time, which state is going to commission its early warning dissemination system? So that if there is a natural disaster like tsunami or something, then people can be warned by just a touch of a button. This has been done in Odisha, which is a coastal state, and therefore lot of Bay of Bengal cyclones. And I mean, Odisha is always troubled by the cyclones. So Odisha has a Naveen Patnaik government, BJD, Biju Janata Dal government. In which country there is a temple that has been found? This is called the Fugan temple, and it has lot of hidden remains. And you know, so this has been found in Chengdu province, downtown Chengdu, and it is in China. It has more than 80 ancient tombs. There is a team comprising of army men. They together climbed Mount Everest without oxygen mask, that is without using additional or supplementary oxygen. This team had 4 people from army. Their name is Konchong Tenda, Kalshang Dorji Bhutia, Kalden Panjur and Sonam Phung Shok. They are army men of India. NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation, which is a which is a Maharatan company, recently installed charging station for electric vehicles at which place? This they did it in Delhi National Capital Region, Delhi NCR, Noida, Gurgaon and all these. And NTPC CEO is Mr. Gurdeep Singh. Another favorite question of examiner. Gurdeep Singh is CEO of NTPC. As per a new report by the Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative, OPHI, what percent of the world's multidimensionally poor children live in India? There are 10 criteria. And if more than one third criteria are met, then the child is called multidimensionally poor. So out of all the multidimensionally poor people in the world, 31% we have in India. And the second country is Nigeria, which has 8%. So you can see the difference between first and second is huge. There will be a theme park that will be based on Lionel Messi, the great football player from Barcelona. He is from Argentina country, named the Messi Experience Park. So Messi Experience Park will be built in which country? It will be built in China. Which country has signed an agreement with China? Gazuba Group Corporation, CGC, to develop a 1200 megawatt hydroelectric power project. This will be the biggest hydro project, which it will be called Budhi Gandaki Hydro Power Project, and it will be in Nepal. Now, my final question for you today. Nepal's new prime minister, write down the name, because Pushpakamal Dahal Prachanda has resigned and Bidya Devi Bhandari is the president. But who is the new prime minister of Nepal? Nepal's capital is Kathmandu, which is the headquarter of SAARC. Which movie will represent India at the 52nd Karlov V. Vary International Film Festival, which will be held in the Czech Republic? Czech Republic capital is Prague. And Czech Republic, you should also know that currency is Koruna. It is a European country, but it does not use Euro. So it's a favorite question of examiners. And the movie name is Ralang Road. After 13 years, any movie will represent India in this festival. Which country recently tested a solid fuel variable flow ramjet, very, very powerful engine? This was done by China. Who has become the first Indian to be nominated as a member of the umpire and referee committee in the ITTF? ITTF, again, it is first time Mr. Ganeshan Nilakanta Iyer. And he has also been recommended as the technical commissioner from the Asia. Our Ministry of Road Transport, Nitin Gadkari is the minister for that, recently inaugurated a bridge. And this bridge was constructed in a record time of only 165 days. It is built on the river Savitri and Kal River. Which state this river is built? This river is built at a cost of 37 crore rupees in Maharashtra. International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, it is headed by World Bank. It has signed a loan agreement of $36 million. Total fund that they need to give is $49 million. This is probably the first tranche of that. For Public Financial Management Capacity Building Program in which state? This state is Himachal Pradesh, which has a Congress government. Veer Bhadra Singh is the Chief Minister. And Acharya Devrat, D-E-V-V-R-A-T, Acharya Devrat is the Governor. NASA has recently renamed the Solar Probe Plus spacecraft after which astrophysicist to pay homage to him? He is the legendary Eugene Parker, and this solar probe will be launched in 2018. By the way, this is the first time NASA has named any of their spacecraft after any living person. Which Bollywood personality has been conferred with the Bharat Gaurav Award given out by the non-resident Indian community of USA? He is the very, very famous director Madhur Bhandarkar. And the awards were also given to Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, founder of Art of Living, Kalpana Chawla, late Kalpana Chawla, again NASA scientist from Karnal, Haryana, Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak, who is the founder of Sulabh Sochalya, and Acharya Lokesh Muni. Who recently set the national record in hammer throw? Previous national record was 62.74 meter by Manju Bala, but her record has been broken by this Sarita Singh. Sarita Singh has thrown the hammer 65.25 meter. So she broke the record by quite a margin. Which bank has announced financing of 100 megawatt rooftop solar project worth rupees 400 crore for private developers under a World Bank program? This has been done by State Bank of India. When do we observe the global day for parents who have such a huge contribution on our lives? For them, the day is 1st of June. And this day was proclaimed by the United Nations General Assembly in 2012. NHB has recently approved the merger of DHFL Vyasa Housing Finance with which other finance company? It is the Aadhar Housing Finance. Which company is going to be the official smartphone sponsor of FIFA World Cup 2018 and 2022? FIFA World Cup 2018 is next year in Russia and 2022 will be in Qatar. And this is a Chinese company called Vivo. Vivo is a Chinese company official, and FIFA's headquarters is in Zurich, and president of FIFA is Gianni Infantino. Who has been elected as the new president of United Nations General Assembly? This is a super important question. And he is the foreign minister of Slovakia. His name is Miroslav Lajak. Miroslav Lajak. Which cricket team recently rebranded itself with a new name? So West Indies will now be called Windies. As simple as that. So West Indies, new name is Windies. Who won the boys singles title at the HCL Asian Junior Tennis Championship, which was held in Pune? Two people you should know. Men's was won by Nitin Kumar Sinha, that is the question. And girls single was won by Mihika Yadav. Who is standing right here? Mihika Yadav. Vinay Dubey has been appointed by which airline as the next CEO? And he will replace Mr. he will replace Mr. Kramer Ball. So Jet Airways has appointed Vinay Dubey as the CEO. India has signed almost a $40 million loan agreement with World Bank for funding a project to improve the access in the delivery of public services in which state? We will improve the public services in Assam. And this project is called Assam Citizen Centric Service Delivery. Total project cost is $49 million. And Assam Chief Minister is Sarbanand Sonowal and Governor is Banwarilal Purohit. Baron and Luthien, it is a book which will be published 100 years after it was first conceived. This book has been written by which person? He is also the author of Lord of the Rings. So now this question is easy. J.R.R. Tolkien. Fifth International Conference of the Society for the Promotion of Indian Classical Music and Culture Among Youth, which is called SPICMACAE, super important, is being held where? It is their fifth international conference. This is going on in IIT Delhi. It's a 7-day conference. What is the name of the hottest planet ever discovered 650 light years away from Earth? The name of the planet is Kelpt 9b, and the temperature on this planet can be as high as 4300 degrees C during daytime. Which team won the UEFA Champions League? They won it for the 12th time. This team is Real Madrid. And Real Madrid is a team from Spain. Coach is the legendary French midfielder Zidane. They beat Italian club Juventus in the final. The scoreline was 4-1. Two goals were scored by Cristiano Ronaldo, who was also named man of the match. These were the superb first week questions. And you can see that, you know, the quality of questions is absolutely mind-boggling. It's amazing. And you will surely find a lot of questions from this video in your coming exam. Okay, bye.